Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Asad International Academy. In 2021, today I am going to explain the efficiency of estimators with easiest and shortcut method which nobody tells you about that. I have divided this lecture in two sections. In first section, I will discuss about that what is the efficiency in statistics, what is efficient, and what is how can we explain the efficiency with that by using an examples, and how efficiency is more efficient, and what is the formula of efficiency which we will use in calculation of efficiency. So this is the first section, and in the last lecture which has second section. In second section, which is the last part, I will discuss about that how to calculate the efficiency with very little and shortcut method. So everything is available in this lecture. So also like this video, because this video will be very helpful and beneficial to you. So without wasting any time, let's start the lecture. So here I'm first of all discussing here what is the efficiency and what is the efficient. So must remember that an unbiased estimator is said to be efficient and unbiased estimator is said to be efficient if variance, very easy definition, if variance of this estimator if variance of this estimator is less than the variance of other estimator. Now going to explain with that example, what is the definition of that? If you have not understood, so just follow the example, you have cleared the point. Suppose that we have two estimators, T1 and T2, are two unbiased estimators, of population parameter theta. Let's suppose we have two estimators T1 and T2, just like simple that. Then must remember T1, which is the first estimator, will be more efficient of variance of T1. WR shows as variance, which is right here, variance of this estimator T1, variance estimator, which that means variance of T1, that's clear, less than the variance of other estimator. So other estimator is 2. I hope that you have cleared the point here. When you have two estimators T1 and T2, then T1 will be more efficient of variance of T1 less than variance of T2. So this is called as efficiency, very easiest definition. Next step, what is the formula of efficiency? Very shortcut method, right here, efficiency of, now going to write the formula of efficiency in statistics. Efficiency of T1 first estimator with T2 always equal to variance of T1 divided by variance of T2. Must remember. And now if you have the opposite section, efficiency of T2 with T1. If you have the opposite section, let's suppose I write here efficiency of T2 with T1. If you have opposition, so write here first of all variance of A2 which is first, and second are right here on dividing side. So this is the formula of efficiency. Efficiency of T1, T2, we write the formula variance of T1 divided by reciprocal. Very shortcut. If we ask about that, efficiency of T2 with T1, second estimator with the first estimator, then we write here variance of T2 divided by reciprocal. Very, very easy. Last step, how efficiency is more efficient? Very, very important question. So write here simply shortcut definition right here. If efficiency is greater than 1, then automatically then T1 will be, must remember that, then T1 will be more efficient. That's clear. So must remember that if efficiency is greater than 1, then T1 will be, first estimate will be more efficient. I hope that you gain a lot of points and concepts which are the very, very easy, that efficiency estimate in statistics. Now in second section, I'm going to explain the second section, which is I will calculate the efficiency in statistics with very, very shortcut method, which is coming now. Now I'm going to explain this example of efficiency of estimators. Now, first of all, before solving this problem, you have to remember the most important secrets and tricks and points which nobody tells you about that. Follow the steps. So, must remember that in calculation of estimators, if you write the question as how to calculate the efficiency, so must remember that most important point. Number one, for efficiency, very, very important points. For efficiency, before the calculation of efficiency, for efficiency, we should firstly check that either T1 and T2 are, which are given, T1, T2 are unbiased or not. Must remember that before the calculation of efficiency in statistics, we should firstly check that either T1 and T2 are unbiased or not. That's clear. Second point. Now, second point is that how can we check the unbiasedness in efficiency? Write in the step, follow the step here. To check the unbiasedness. Of T1 and T2, we should take expectation. Must remember expectation. So must remember that second point. To check the unbiasedness of T2, we should take expectation. That's clear. So this is the main problem. Now I'm going to practically solving this problem, but I have asked that. So here, first of all, given here, estimate, take the estimator T1. So let's take the T1, x1 plus 2x2 divided by 4. So you have to first of all calculate the expectation right here, taking expectation on both sides. Taking the expectation of T1, simply write here expectation of bracket x1 plus 2x2 divided by 4. That's clear. Next step is here, write here expectation of x1 as it is, because 2 is a constant, because expectation of 2x2 will be, 2 will be outside, expectation of x2. So write here 2 expectation of x2 divided by 4. That's clear. You already know that expectation of x always equal to mu. So we write here just simply mu plus 2 as it is, expression will be mu divided by 4. That's clear. Next, if 2 plus 1 will be 3, 3 mu divided by 4. So I have calculated there, expectation of t1 is equal to mu. Right here, expectation of t1 is equal to 3 by 4 mu. So you can write here, so t1 is unbiased estimator. Right here, so t1 is unbiased estimator. That's clear. Unbiased estimator. I have already discussed the definition of unbiasedness. This lecture I have already discussed. You can watch that lecture in the description below the video. So that's clear. So first of all, you have to take the expectation. That's clear. Now, and similarly, you can take the expectation of T2 himself. Then next lecture will be here. Last point, you have to calculate the efficiency of T1 with T2. So this formula I already discussed about that. Variance of T1 divided by variance of T2, which is the formula of efficiency which I have recently discussed. So first of all, you have to calculate the variance, and second, you have to calculate the variance. So right here, that's clear point. So variance right here, T1, I take T1 is equal to X1. So I take the T2 now. T2 is equal to X1 plus X2 plus X3 divided by 3. So now you have to calculate the variance on both sides. You can write here, first of all, must remember that you will know that variance of AX, you will know that variance of AX always equal to A square variance of X. You will already know the formula of that. Variance of AX always equal to A square variance of X. You can write here, first of all, 1 over 3 outside, X1 plus X2 plus X3. That's clear. Now, I will take the variance on both sides. Variance of T2 is equal to variance of 1 over 3 bracket X1 plus X2 plus X3 bracket close. That's clear. Next step, variance of AX equal to A square variance of X. Right here, 1 over 3 completing square variance of X. And that's, you can write here X1 plus X2 plus X3. That's clear. So now write here 1 over 3 is the Y. And variance of X oscillated, variance of X1, variance of X2, and next we write here variance of X3. You don't write that variance is the sigma square. You don't know that variance of X is equal to sigma square. So you can write here simply 1 over 9 bracket sigma square plus sigma square plus sigma square. That's clear. So variance of T2 is equal to, we can write here, where T variance T2 is equal to 1 plus 2 plus 3, you write here 3 sigma square divided by 9, 3 by the 3 is the 9, so 1 over 3 sigma square. I have calculated the variance of T2. Similarly, you can calculate the variance of T1. Putting the values in variance of T1 and variance of T, dividing that, you can calculate the efficiency. So I hope that you have again a lot of points and concepts. If you have not understood anything, you can talk me through comment section. Thanks for watching the video. If you like this video, then kindly must subscribe to my YouTube channel and must press bell icon button. You can press the all notification. If you press the all notification button, you will get the notification of my new lecture. A new lecture is coming soon. I hope that you have point that clear. Goodbye.